Piecewise-Defined Functions, Level 1. At times, a function is defined differently on different parts of its domain. For example, the function f of x equals x squared looks like this. And for the most part, its domain is all real numbers. In other words, this function's domain is defined from negative infinity to positive infinity. This function has no inherent restrictions in its domain, but we are free to restrict the domain whenever it's necessary. For example, say that I only want to define or turn on this function when the values of x are greater than 0. Using inequalities, we will express this restriction as follows. X is greater than 0. This means that the function will be visible on the right side of the Cartesian coordinate, where the values of x are positive. Now notice that there is an open circle at x equals 0. This was a result of setting the restriction x is greater than 0. Notice that we are not considering 0 to be part of the domain. So the value that the function attains at x equals 0 is left out from the picture. But if we want to include it, we simply change the restriction to x is greater than or equal to 0, like this. Then that open circle becomes a closed circle. Notice that the new domain is now from 0 to infinity, as opposed to the usual domain from negative infinity to positive infinity, or all real numbers. Now let's say that I am only interested on the interval between 0 inclusive, meaning I include 0, which we represent by using a closed circle, and 2 exclusive, meaning I don't include 4 in the domain. This is represented with an open circle. The inequality that will describe this restriction on the domain will be represented using inequalities as follows. X is between 0 and 2. And now the graph looks as follows. The function is only defined between 0 and 2, excluding the value that the function attains at x equals 2. But again, if we want this particular value to join the domain, we simply include it by changing this part of the inequality with a less than or equal symbol, like this. Now the open circle becomes a closed circle. As you just saw, we can turn off and on certain parts of the domain of any particular function by setting a rule or restriction that describes a new domain. Now let's take the unrestricted domain of the function and restrict a certain value of the domain. For example, let's say that I do not want to include x equals 2 as part of the domain of this function. This means that the value that this function attains at x equals 2 will be turned off and replaced with an open circle. This means that the function is not defined at this particular value of the domain. The inequality that is used to represent this restriction is expressed as follows. X does not equal 2. This means that the domain of this function is defined everywhere except at x equals 2. The function will now look like this. Notice that there is a hole or a gap in the function where x equals 2. There is a gap because we set a restriction. That restriction was that x cannot equal 2. So this portion of the function is undefined or turned off and is not visible because of the current restriction. If I wanted to add another gap, say at x equals negative 2, I would add the following inequality to the description of the domain. X cannot equal negative 2. And the graph will now look like this. The domain will be defined everywhere except at x equals 2 and x equals negative 2. And we would have two gaps in the domain because at those points, the domain is restricted or turned off. Okay, now what if we wanted to do the opposite of creating gaps and I only want a certain point of the function to be expressed? Well, say that I want to turn on the function only at x equals negative 2. The inequality that describes this domain is expressed as follows. X is equal to negative 2. This means that the function will be defined only at x equals negative 2 and will look like this. Now say that I also wanted to include the point at x equals 2. So then I would add the expression x equals 2 to the restriction in the domain. So now the graph will look like this. Once again, notice that only the points at x equals negative 2 and x equals 2 are visible or turned on. Everything else is turned off and hidden from view. Alright, for the most part, those are all the types of restrictions that you will encounter when you work with piecewise defined functions. A piecewise defined function has the following general form. It's called a piecewise defined function because the main function, in this case capital F of x, is created or defined by two or more separate functions whose domain is restricted in a certain way. This restriction is described after the if statement. You can think of these restrictions as subdomains of the overall piecewise defined function. The easiest way to draw piecewise defined functions is to 1. First identify and graph one function at a time without any restrictions You should have your library of functions handy. If you're not familiar how a function should look like, you can download a library of functions sheet in the Precalculus section of this website. Second, apply the restrictions, erasing any portion of the graph where the function is not defined, according to the inequality given. Then systematically apply steps 1 and 2 to the rest of the functions. Alright, let's go over various examples. Let's graph the first piecewise defined function, f of x equals x if x is greater than 0, and negative x if x is less than 0. Alright, notice that this piecewise defined function has two distinct functions, specifically x and negative x. Let's first graph x. You should be familiar with this function. It's an identity function. In other words, a line with a positive slope equal to 1 that passes through the origin. Okay, the function that was just graphed is the unrestricted form. Now we need to look at the restriction given to us and apply it. We see that x has to be greater than or equal to 0. So we start erasing the function up to x equals 0, where we include a closed circle because it's greater than or equal to. Okay, that's the first part of the piecewise defined function. Now we go ahead and graph the second function, negative x. Again, you should be able to identify this function. This is a line with a negative slope of 1 that passes through the origin. Now that we have our graph of f of x equals negative x, we apply the restriction defined by x is less than 0. This means that everything to the left of 0 is left intact and erase everything to the right of the function. So doing that, we have the following. Notice that we should include an open circle at x equals 0. But because the first function is defined at x equals 0, the closed circle overrides the open circle. And there you have it. This is how the piecewise defined function looks like. It's really not that hard. It just looks intimidating, but it's actually relatively simple. Now take a closer look at the graph. This graph looks awfully familiar. It's the absolute value function, f of x equals the absolute value of x. This is actually how this function is defined. It is a piecewise defined function in disguise. For convenience, we just use the absolute value symbol to describe the function, but keep in mind that this is how the absolute value function is defined. Alright, let's graph the next piecewise defined function, f of x equals 2x if x does not equal 0, and 1 if x is equal to 0. We first need to graph the function 2x. This is a line with slope 2 and y-intercept of 0. So it will look like this. Now we apply the restriction. In this case, the restriction says that x cannot equal 0. So this function will be defined everywhere except at x equals 0. So there will be a gap at x equals 0, like this. Now we graph the second function, 1, a constant function. In other words, a line with 0 slope with a y-intercept of 1. And it will look like this. Now, according to the restriction, x is equal to 0, this function is only defined at this particular x value. So we are only interested on the point 0, 1. So we erase everything except the point 0, 1. It's perfectly normal for piecewise defined functions to have gaps in certain areas, and then a closed circle at a point above or below the gap. Notice that this piecewise defined function is still considered a function because it passes the vertical line test. So there are no issues with the way it looks. It is still considered a function. Alright, let's try one with three distinct functions. F of x equals x plus 3 if x is between negative 2, inclusive, and 1, exclusive. 5 if x is equal to 1, and negative x plus 2 if x is greater than 1. We first graph the first function, x plus 3. This is a line with slope of 1 and y-intercept of 3. Now that we have the graph, we apply the restriction to the domain. Here we restrict the domain at the interval negative 2 inclusive to 1 exclusive. So we need a closed circle at x equals negative 2 and an open circle at x equals 1. In addition, we need to erase everything except the values between negative 2 and 1. So doing that, we have the following. Now we graph the second function. This is a constant function, a line with 0 slope and a y-intercept of 5. The restriction on this function is x is equal to 1. We only want the point at x equals 1. In other words, the only part of the function that will be visible will be the point 1, 5. Finally, we graph the third and last function. This function is a line with slope equal to negative 1 and y-intercept of 2. So it will look like this. And finally, the only part of the graph that will be visible is where the values of x are greater than 1. So we add an open circle at x equals 1 and draw a line from this point and on. And this is how this particular piecewise defined function looks like. Alright, let's work on the final example. F of x equals negative x plus 1 if x is between negative 1, inclusive, and 1 exclusive. 2 if x is equal to 1, and x squared if x is greater than 1. Alright, the first function is a line with slope of negative 1 and y-intercept of 1. The domain of this function is restricted between negative 1 inclusive and 1 exclusive, and will look like this. The second function is a constant function passing through y equals 2, and according to the restriction, we are only interested on the point at x equals 1. In other words, the point 1, 2. That would look like this. And finally, the third function is a quadratic function. You should be familiar with this function by now. This function looks like this. And we are only interested on the values that are greater than 1. So we erase everything to the left of 1, and we obtain the final graph of the piecewise defined function. And there you have it. That's how you graph piecewise defined functions. First, make sure you identify and graph the individual functions with no restrictions, other than the function's inherent restrictions, if they have any. And then you apply any restrictions given by the if statement, erasing any portions that are not turned on, based on the restrictions given. Okay, in our next video, we will be analyzing piecewise defined functions after we have successfully graphed them.